Hello students, today I am going to explain chapter 2. Is metal rather pure? Part 6. We have to know about the heterogeneous mixture in the form of suspensions. What is a suspension? A suspension is a heterogeneous mixture in which the small particles of a solid are spread throughout the liquid without dissolving in it. For example, chalk and water mixture, in which we see that the particles of chalk float on the surface of water or they settle down at the bottom. So they are suspension. Another word is muddy water. In muddy water we see that particles of mud flow in the throughout the water, and if we leave it undisturbed for 4 to 6 hours, the mud settle down at the bottom. And last one is milk of magnesia. Milk of magnesia is also suspension in which the mixture show heterogeneous nature. So how we know about the suspension? The suspension is known by the properties. So what are the properties of suspension? First one, it is a heterogeneous mixture. It is a heterogeneous mixture. That means it has no uniform composition throughout its bulk. Second one, the size of solid particles in a suspension. The size of solid particles in a suspension is quite large. It is larger than 100 nanometer. Larger than 100 nanometer in diameter. Third one is the particles of suspension can be seen easily. Fourth one is the particles of a suspension do not pass through a printer paper, so they can be separated by compression. Fifth one, the suspensions are unstable. The particles of a suspension settle down after some time. Last one is suspension scatters beam of light passing through it. Now we have take another heterogeneous mixture, and which is last one, that is known as colloid. What is a colloid? A colloid is a kind of solution in which the size of solid particles is intermediate. Intermediate, that means between those in the true solution and those in the suspensions. They appear to be homogeneous to us, but actually they are found to be heterogeneous when observed through a high power microscope. For example, soap solution is a kind of suspension, starch solution is a kind of suspension, milk is a kind of solution, ink is a kind of solution, suspension. In the process of separating the particles of suspension and by characterizing the suspension, we know about a special effect that is known as Tyndall effect, that is observed, first of all observed by Tyndall. So this effect is known as Tyndall effect. What is the Tyndall effect? The scattering of light by colloidal particles is known as Tyndall effect. The scattering of light of colloidal particles is known by colloidal particles is known as Tyndall effect. Now we have to know that properties of colloids. What are the properties of colloids? First one is it appears to be homogeneous, but actually it is a heterogeneous. The size of the particles in colloid is bigger than those in the true solution, but smaller than those in the suspension. It is between 1 nanometer and 100 nanometer in diameter. Third property, the particles of most of the colloids cannot be seen even with a microscope. The particles, fourth one is, the particles of a colloid can pass through a printer paper. So, a colloid cannot be separated affected by filtration. Fifth one, the colloids are quite stable. They do not separate out on heating. And sixth one is, a colloid scatters a beam of light. Colloid scatters a beam of light passing through it. So, by this characteristic, we can characterize a given colloid. Now, we have to know about the classification of colloids, because colloids have several types. And how can we classify colloids? A colloid can be classified on the basis of physical state of dispersed phase, that means solute, and the dispersion medium, that is known as solvent. So they are classified into sol, solid sol, aerosol, emulsion, foam, solid foam, and gel. These are the seven groups of colloids that are defined in next class. You have to do the all the very short and short questions of first segment of the chapter 2, and till then goodbye.